I'm going to begin this unit with an old problem known as the water pouring problem. Here's what we're given is two glasses of water, and we have a faucet and a sink, which can be the source of as much water as we want. Now, these glasses are of different sizes. I haven't drawn them that much different, but this one is 4 ounces, and this one is 9 ounces. For those of you in the rest of the world besides the U.S., an ounce is about 30 milliliters. Our goal is to measure out a specific amount of water, and what we want to have is 6 ounces of water measured out. So 6 ounces won't fit in this glass, so the idea is at the end, we want to have this glass filled with exactly 6 ounces of water. And there's no gradated markers. It's not like a graduated cylinder or a measuring cup where we have the measurements on the glass. And it wouldn't be accurate enough to just eyeball it. So what we've got to do is we've got to figure out how to do that by measuring out precise amounts into the cups and pouring them off. For example, if the goal had been 5 ounces, then that would have been easy. We just fill the 9 ounce all the way up to the top, and then pour the 9 ounce into the 4 ounce until the 4 ounce is all the way full. And then what would be remaining here, because there's 9 altogether, would be 5 in this glass. So 5 ounces is easy. 6 ounces, it's not as obvious how to get there. So the puzzle is to find a sequence of pouring actions, and the pouring can be from one glass to another, it can go in the other direction, it can go from the faucet into each of the glasses, and it can go from the glasses down the drain. So 6 different actions we can take, and we want to find a sequence of actions that arrives at this goal of 6 ounces. And of course, we can generalize the problem and put any number rather than 9, 4, and 6. So as usual, let's make our inventory of concepts that we're going to be dealing with. We have the glass, and the glass has a capacity and a current level. So this glass would have capacity 9, current level 5. We are also going to need a collection of glasses, probably, the pair of glasses. And I guess we can say that the pair of glasses and their current levels, that represents a complete state of the world. So we'll think of that as a state of the world, everything we need to know about where we are in the problem. Then we have the goal that we're trying to reach. We have the pouring actions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that breaks down into emptying, filling, and transferring. And the transferring, I think, is a little bit tricky because there's 2 ways to do it. When we were transferring from the 9 ounce into the 4 ounce, so we transfer from X to Y, we can do that until Y is full. That's what happened here. The 4 ounce was full. Or we could do it until X is empty. If we were started to pour back 4 ounces from here into an empty one, we could do it until it was empty. So anything else in the inventory? Oh, well, we certainly need a notion of a solution. A solution is going to be a sequence of steps to pour from here to here, then from here to the drain, then fill up, then pour again, and so on. And so what this unit is really all about is techniques for finding these solutions, which are sequences of steps. And again, we're always talking about managing complexity in this class. So the complexity we're trying to manage here is a complexity that comes when the sequences are long.